here's my memory of, okay. of this thing, or at least we've always talked about, like...
You mean I wasn't the hero of your story?
Everything that you say you did, I remember myself doing. But seriously, we've talked about the foolscap method and how at the start of a book, you got to know the ending, all of the things, right? Theme, genre, act one, act two, act three. So I remember that I very much knew where the book was going to end, which was when the paratroopers got to the Western Wall, the Wailing Wall, because that was, again, reclaiming by force of arms the soul center of the Jewish people.
Yes.
That was sort of the concept of the book. So I remember that, and I remember thinking that the structure of the book was going to be not to do an exhaustive thing about the tanks did this and the planes did that, but to pick, sort of like Band of Brothers, to pick, you know, three or four. I knew I wanted, since the air war, the preemptive strike was a big part of it. Tell me if I'm making all this up.
No, you're not.
It was clear in my mind that there was going to have to be, we were going to have to follow some pilots, and the tank war, crossing Sinai to Suez Canal, we're going to have that. And then the other big thing was the liberation of the Western Wall, the paratroopers that went through the Lion's Gate and liberated that. So I thought, okay, those three threads, I'll just have to go over there, find the people. Mm-hmm. But it was very much treated, between you and me, as I remember this, like a novel.
Yeah.
As if you were making it up, but we had the real facts from history.
And then, right.
So I knew that there was going to be a scene, an emotional scene at the Wailing Wall at the end. That was the emotional climax of the book. But what I didn't know was what it would be. And that would depend on the real people that we found, right? It would depend on, you know, finding Yoram Zamosh and having him tell what he, and that hopefully that was going to be even better than anything you could make up, you know, because it would be real.
Yeah.
So the book proposal served, as well as selling the book, as a foolscap page for me, the writer, so I knew what I was doing. So when I got to Israel, I wasn't just, well, what am I doing next?
Right.
I knew what I was going to do.
How do you transform yourself from a fiction writer to a guy who actually has to go get the story?
It was really hard. I'm an American Jew writer that they've never heard of. I have no credentials. I had real performance anxiety as I was going into these interviews.